Hi guys, welcome back to Vlogmas. Vlogmas day nine. This month's really flying by. Tonight I've come to Temple Tube Station, and Temple's right on the bank of the river. If you look behind me, we're right on the north bank of the River Thames. I'm heading back up that way to Somerset House. I'm headed to meet Chloe and check out this year's ice skating rink. We're going to get a drink. We're not going skating tonight. We will be going skating hopefully later this week. But let's just check out the view while we're down here. Just through there we have the Shard, Oxo building. All of that is the South Bank Centre. The London Eye. You might just be able to make out in the background through there, Big Ben. Right, let's head up to Somerset House. Guess it's bell ringing practice. Somerset House is here on London Strand, and its huge open courtyard make it one of London's most impressive 18th century buildings.
Okay, this is it. Welcome to Somerset House. This spectacular neoclassical building right in the heart of London sits between the Strand and the River Thames. And when it was originally built, the Thames hadn't been embanked, so you could sail a boat right in here. Today, the building that's here sits on the original site of a Tudor royal palace and is one of London's architectural greats. It was designed by Sir William Chambers and constructed between 1785 and 1803, originally to accommodate government offices, including the Navy Board and various societies. The wings either side, they were added in about 1856. The use of the buildings as offices for civil servants meant that it was essentially closed to the public during the whole of the 20th century, with the courtyard actually being used as a car park, a government car park. Then a campaign was mounted in the late 20th century to bring the buildings back into public use, and now Somerset House is a unique part of the London cultural scene. It's got a great location here in London's West End and Theatre District, and it's now a vital element of the nation's heritage, where the arts are presented with insight and passion, and the spaces are brought to life with surprising and original events for a government building like this one.
Looks pretty good, huh?
Cut a long story short, in the late 1990s, the building was put into trust, and they've converted many of the upper floors into commercial office space, which is let out, and they've let some of the perimeter rooms as bars and restaurants. And in fact, there's a lovely little bar which serves food in the south wing down there, which has this amazing terrace, and this is a great spot in the summer. There's loads of tables and chairs out here. It's a bit dark right now, so you can't see, but we're overlooking the River Thames, which is behind me. It's very dark right now, but in the summer, this is a great spot. You can get a drink, sit outside in the sunshine, and below the ice rink is actually an amazing fountain which they turn on in the summer months. And the money the Trust raise from letting out the office space, letting out the bars and restaurants, and I guess commercial events like this one, the skating, they provide an income for the restoration and considerable maintenance that a building like this requires. But also, a lot of the space is open to the public, so it obviously provides the income required to make that possible. And it's effectively, certainly this whole south wing is an arts and culture centre. The ice rink opened in mid-November and is open until the 10th of January, and there are two bars and restaurants here, the Skate Lodge and with Fortnum & Masons being the sponsor and patron of the event, there's the Fortnum's Lodge, which is a bar and restaurant, and in the west wing of Somerset House, Fortnum & Masons have set up a pop-up department store.
Just found Chloe and we're heading into the Fortnum & Mason Lounge and Christmas Arcade. Should we find the bar? Through the ladies' gift section. Lapre ski that way. Lodge. I think it's the lodge. Chloe and I are at the Fortnum's Lodge at Somerset House, and I've gone for the botanical gin and salmon tasting experience. What are you having?
Camera shy.
Oh, that sounds good. So
cherry chocolate.
Heppel is a new British gin, and for the tasting experience at Somerset House, they've broken it down into some of the botanicals that flavour the finished gin. So you have the base spirit, Douglas fir, green juniper, and ripe juniper. And then the finished gin, which combines them all and more with tonic. Also, you have some salmon smoked on the roof of Fortnum's in Piccadilly using the same botanicals as the gin.
Perfect Instagram shot. The Douglas fir one is pretty strong. The salmon has been smoked on the room called Flexus using the same botanicals as the gin.
Thank you.
really enjoyed that. Camera shy.
Okay, we're going to head into the skate lodge and get a couple of glasses of warm mulled wine that we can enjoy while we watch some of the skating.
Thanks for watching, guys. If you like this video, please hit the thumbs up like button. If you'd like to be the first to see my new films, the subscribe button. Merry Christmas, and I'll see you tomorrow. Toodles. Do you want to say goodbye? Camera shy. Toodles.